Icarus, the most distant star ever seen. Anyone who's ever gazed deep into the dull, soulless eyes of a Kardashian will know what it's like to view a distant star. But in April of this year, the Hubble telescope detected a star even more distant, 9 billion light years away, to be precise. Strange Mysteries would like to introduce you to the MACS J1149+2223 Lens Star 1, aka Icarus, the most distant star we have ever seen. The discovery. The identification of Icarus was outlined in a paper called Extreme Magnification of an Individual Star at Redshift 1.5 by a Galaxy Cluster Lens, which was authored by Patrick Kelly of the University of Minnesota and a hell of a lot of other people back in October 2017. The results of this paper were published in Nature Astronomy on April 2nd, and they revealed that the discovery of Icarus owed much to Lady Luck. When Icarus was found, Minnesota's astronomers were actually trying to view a supernova called SN Refsdal when Icarus was spotted in what Bob Ross would call a happy little accident. At 9 billion light years away, this star is so distant it shouldn't be viewable by us Earthlings, since it is around 100 times further than our fanciest star-spotting telescopes are able to reach at present. The only things we can see beyond this limit are supernova explosions, massive structures like the GN-Z11 galaxy spotted by Hubble 2 years ago, and of course your girlfriend's considerably proportioned derriere. So if the Icarus star is beyond our viewing capabilities, how exactly did Kelly's team find it? Simple. The universe pulled a magic trick called gravitational lensing. Gravitational lensing happens when an astronomical body is of sufficient mass that its gravity becomes powerful enough to bend light. This in turn creates a magnifying effect when viewing objects behind the areas of space affected. Let's take the example of your delightfully thick girlfriend. If she was stood in front of one of those charts they have when you're getting your eyes tested, you could theoretically cheat by moving her into position so that her substantial buttocks magnified the light coming from the test towards you, if she were big enough. The truth is, nobody's girlfriend is large enough to bend light. You'd need a whole heap of chunky ladies before you're even close. This was also the case with the discovery of Icarus, as Hubble's observation of the star required the combined gravity of a cluster of galaxies found 5 billion light years away in the constellation Leo. The Minnesota team were actually using this cluster to view the aforementioned SN Refsdal supernova, but during their observations, they spotted a region which seemed to be getting brighter for an unknown reason. Further investigation revealed that the random brightness was caused by a star traveling through the cluster. And at just the right moment, this star also passed directly in front of Icarus. The gravitational lensing caused by the galaxy cluster had already magnified the light in this region by a factor of 2,000. But this passing star also made Icarus 4 times brighter, allowing us to see this magnified distant sun in all its glory. What a magnificent stroke of luck. The blue supergiant. Icarus may be 9 billion light years away, but we're still able to figure out a few things about it. In fact, just like your peeping neighbor with his long lens camera, we're able to watch from afar and get all excited as we view something we really shouldn't be able to see. Icarus is located in a distant spiral galaxy within the constellation Leo, and we believe it would have been a blue supergiant hundreds of thousands of times larger than our sun. The use of the past tense there is deliberate, because whereas blue supergiants like this were common in the early universe, these hot, bright stars tend to burn out and die rather quickly. You know, like Kurt Cobain did, or Justin Bieber hopefully will. Interestingly, despite their rarity, many of the stars you see in the night sky are blue supergiants due to their incredible luminosity. They're like vegans in that respect, in that there may not be many of them, but damn, they sure make themselves known. Sadly, Icarus is probably long gone by now, as being 9 billion light years away means its light has taken 9 billion years to reach our planet. When the photons of light were ejected by Icarus into the depths of space, our solar system still had another 4.4 billion years to go before it would even form. Basically, when we look at Icarus, we are seeing it as it was 9 billion years ago. We are viewing a star as it appeared when the universe was just 30% of its current age. Man, I wish I could do that with my girlfriend. But don't worry, she's 60, so it's legal. I mean, I did the math. And so did the space scientists, who have calculated that blue supergiants like Icarus are unlikely to last as long as 9 billion years. Kelly's team believes that Icarus's most likely fate was to collapse into a black hole or neutron star many billions of years ago. Such remote observations are therefore fascinating to cosmologists, who are able to see direct evidence of what our universe looked like billions of years before we showed up to the party. Oh, and it also helps to understand dark matter, which is pretty neat. The distant answer. Dark matter is the curious substance which we know makes up 27% of our universe, but whose properties, composition, and favorite deli meats remain a mystery. The team at Minnesota wanted to help crack this case, and so they used their observations of Icarus to test a theory which claims that dark matter is made of black holes. Oh yeah, you better believe we're covering that topic on Strange Mysteries soon. There have been many proponents of this theory, but the most recent paper published on the topic came on March 23rd from J.R. Espinoza, D. Rocco, and A. Rioto. I don't know, their first names were just not that close. The paper was called Cosmological Signature of the Standard Model Higgs Vacuum Instability, Primordial Black Holes as Dark Matter, and it was published in the journal Physical Review Letters. In this publication, Mr. Espinoza, Rocco, and Rioto explore whether dark matter is comprised of teeny tiny black holes which are created by the Big Bang. Antonio Rioto, whose name I just Googled, was quoted as saying that in principle, this explanation may account for all dark matter. So, what has this got to do with Icarus? Well, if you'll calm down and put your pants back on, I'll tell you. When Icarus was discovered, the team at Minnesota were able to look back through decades of Hubble images of the region to see how it appeared before we knew of its existence. Kinda like looking back at your old family photos, only to see your creepy uncle leering at you in the background. When old images of Icarus were analyzed, it became clear that Icarus's brightness remained stable over a long period of time. This seems to disprove the black hole dark matter theory, as its luminosity would have varied if it was in the presence of a swarm of black holes. Neither this theory nor the incredible observations of a distant star would have been possible without the magnificent Hubble telescope. And according to the press release which announced Icarus's discovery, a favorable movement of galaxies in the future may allow us to amplify the star's image by as much as 10,000 times using gravitational lensing. By the time this happens, Kelly and his team believe we'll likely be using the forthcoming James Webb Space Telescope to view both Icarus and many other distant objects in the universe. And we're going to further explore the possibilities of this new technology over on Patreon in our bonus video, Potential Discoveries of the James Webb Telescope, which you can access at patreon.com/strangemysteries. For a $2 a month pledge, which you can cancel at any time, you'll get to watch this and all of our bonus content, which goes deeper and darker into every topic than YouTube allows. If you don't want to donate, then...
Bull. We know you wanted more. Strange Mysteries on YouTube and our Patreon bonus videos weren't enough to quench your search for truth, to give you that sense of awe and wonder again, to go past what you thought was the end, to give you the answers you seek, but which only lead to more questions. That's why we just upped the stakes. Chemicals of reality. Reality, consciousness, brains. What else is there? Ask yourself that question. Perhaps that's all there really is, but perhaps everything else is found within a place where these ideas, these things, overlap. Some thing, some place that is undefinable. To many people, altering certain chemicals in their brains produces what they would simply call hallucinations. In fact, what we're going to discuss specifically used to be called the businessman's trip, as one could enjoy it. Come down and put your pants back on in the time it takes to eat lunch. It wasn't taken seriously. Well, unless, of course, you started digging. And some people, including us, did. Already, though, to many people, this chemical is special amongst others. Very special. To them, it represents something more meaningful and incredible, as if it's the gateway to the next level of consciousness. The ticket to a higher reality barely explored by most humans. It is the entry point to a new reality visited by only a select few whose minds have become enlightened through the use of this exotic substance. For this reason, it's commonly referred to as the spirit molecule. But is its reputation as a mystical mind opener deserved? Or is it and everything it represents just a load of bullshit? We look at, investigate, and dive deeply into nearly all available research regarding this question from nearly every angle feasible. And in the course of doing so, stumble upon unexplainable patterns, correlations, and neurological evidence for a reality existing beyond this one. Watch this hour-long Strange Mysteries premium video, Chemicals of Reality, as well as many more to come by becoming an elite premium member of our Patreon at patreon.com/strangemysteries.